Happy Easter, everyone. I hope you're safe and enjoying this Sunday off with your family. This week, I want to concentrate on canine aggression. Why do animals fight? Why do dogs fight each other? Why do they fight with us? Why do they attack us and other dogs? I want to spend time working with, teaching you about, and also how to train reactive dogs, dogs that inherently aggressive, whether it be out of fear, it doesn't matter. This week will be devoted for any of you out there that feel that you have a potentially aggressive dog. Now, to really understand this, I'm not going to gloss over it. I'm going to take a broad view, but I'm also going to hit on a few areas that I'm going to break it down like a periodic table. And why am I going to do that? Because the deeper understanding that you have of aggression, why it occurs, why it's so natural, if you can wrap your head around that, that's the foundation for moving forward. That's the first step that we have to take. You can't sit there and believe that your animal attacked someone because it was angry at that person, or because it was jealous, or because they did something to provoke it, in which they may have. But to really understand aggression, you have to understand nature and why she even developed it in the first place. So today I'm going to talk about the evolution of aggression among animals. This is really important. It's going to break it down to a periodic table, and we're actually going to play a game today in explaining it. But if you stick with me this week, I promise you by the end of this week, you'll know more about canine aggression than you've ever thought possible that you can know. And if you certainly own one of these dogs, you're going to be more equipped than you've ever been. That is my promise to you, because canine aggression is my wheelhouse. This is what I seem to know better than anything else, or at least that's what I'm told. So let's get started. First things first, why do animals fight? You know, when you think about it, fighting is dangerous. It's extremely dangerous. And if not, it comes with a huge metabolic cost, I cannot tell you how much. So that alone makes you think, why would I fight you? Well, the reason being is that life at its most fundamental level is an exchange of energy for more energy. More energy. Well, how do you get that if the demand is greater than the supply? In other words, you're governed by law of limited resources. That means at some point, you as an animal and the other animal as an individual will want the same resource. You're going to want it. And natural selection behooves the individual to basically build the individual who can pass forward their genes. So it looks after the fitness of that individual, not the weaker individual. So what happens when you encounter someone, or you as an animal encounter another animal, and you want the same resource, you need that same resource for your own fitness or that of your offspring, and yet the other animal doesn't want to give it up. And that's all that there is. Well, to help you understand this and break this down a little bit today, we're actually going to employ what's called game theory. Now, game theory is pretty neat because it was developed years and years ago by economists who wanted to predict the human behavior in certain financial markets. Well, this thing was broken down basically and borrowed by, most notably, John Maynard Smith in Animal Behaviors back in the 1970s. He said, can I borrow your game theory here and use your mathematical formula? Because I want to use it to predict the optimal animal behavior when you take into account the other animal's behavior. So let's play this game together and have a little bit of fun. Like in all games, there are players. You've got to have players in the game. The players in this game will be combatant animals. Combatant animals. Again, I want the resource, you want the resource. This talking's not getting it done. So therefore, there is a resource, there is a prize that we both want. Well, we have a strategy we get to employ in this game. And the strategy is only one of two. You either employ what we call a hawk strategy. Now, these are not hawks, these are animals, could be a hawk, but I'm just trying to put a visual reference to the strategy. So the hawk strategy is this. When you see the resource and you see a combatant, you immediately attack. You immediately attack without hesitation because you want that resource. So that is the hawk strategy, to immediately attack. The dove strategy is either to flee or to display. And when I say display, That's all that stuff that you see dogs do. Their hackles come up, tail comes up, they puff out, show their teeth, growl, all that sort of stuff. Those are visual displays, because you're trying to avoid physically fighting your opponent. So that's your strategy. You only get to use one or the two. You're either hawking, you immediately attack, or you're a dove and you flee or display. And whenever a hawk meets an animal, in other words, an animal utilizing the hawk strategy meets another animal using the hawk strategy, you have a 50% chance of winning the resource. Same thing with a dove to dove, a 50% chance. Now, what we're going to do in this game is we're going to measure the payoff of each strategy. So in the original game theory, the payoff was measured in currency, but we're going to change the currency to units of fitness. In other words, how many calories do you gain? The number of calories gained by gaining the resource and by now using your strategy against your opponent, or the number of calories lost, or the number of offspring you're able to produce by using the strategy. So now we set that up. We have one more value that we have to establish, the value of the resource. And today we're going to assign the value of 30 plus 30 units, 30 units of fitness right here. That's what that value is. And the value, and this was the value that was originally used because they determined that that was just enough for life sustaining energy. Notice I said just enough for life sustaining energy, meaning it maintained my personal fitness, which allowed that personal fitness to maintain the fitness of my offspring. And that's it. There's no extra to it, just enough. But then there's a cost. So we're going to go ahead and assign this as a benefit, because I told you everything that we do, we always run it through a cost-benefit analysis, whether you're conscious of that or not, we still do it. Well, now here comes a couple of costs. And one of those, I'm going to assign the value W. I'm going to use the letter W to describe what's called being wounded. That's a cost. If an animal using a hawk strategy immediately attacks another animal using the hawk strategy that immediately attacks, someone's going to be wounded. And that wounding comes with a cost, a big cost. So we're going to assign the value of negative 60. And then there's the dove strategy. That's a cost as well. You can't go around puffing up, throwing your chest out there, getting that tail up there, strutting around, growling, staring for nothing. That requires energy. Energy. So we're going to assign a value of minus 5 to it. So this is what John Maynard Smith did and so many other behaviors since then, ethologists. They've taken these values, taken these strategies and these players and plugged it into this little formula. And it may look complicated, but it's really not. And I'll just kind of run it through real quick. So here's your two opponents. We got like opponent one over here and opponent number two. Okay, so opponent one wants to determine that there is a resource. I want it. But his opponent, and he's going to utilize the hawk strategy. But the opponent decides, no, I'm using the hawk strategy. So they both utilize the hawk strategy. So now we have our value of 30 right here minus the 60. And of course, when you do that math, we're going to end up with a minus 30. And then because you only have a 50% chance of winning the resource if you encounter an animal using the same strategy, we have to divide that by 2. So by the time we get done, we come up with a negative 15 is the payoff for any time an animal uses the hawk strategy and gets another animal using the hawk strategy. Now, if he encounters an animal using the dove strategy, sweet, easy day, immediate plus 30 value right then and there, because he just ran into a dove. That dove's either going to flee or just get the heck out of town. Either way, he's not going to fight him back. So now down here at the bottom, now I have the animal decides on this particular day, he's going to use the dove strategy, meaning I'm not going to fight, I'm going to flee because I just encountered an opponent who wants to use the hawk strategy. If you're going to use dove against a hawk, you're going to lose every day of the week. So therefore, they achieve no currency, no units of fitness, zero. I don't really lose any, because I'm not going to be wounded, because I'm not going to deal with him. I'm not going to fight him over that resource. I'm just going to leave. And then if a dove encounters another dove, though, meaning I'm an animal employing the dove strategy and you're an animal employing the dove strategy, Well, let's see who can put up the biggest show here. Strut around, show my stuff, left, right, just do everything, pace back and forth, you name it, growl. And finally, someone goes, well, I don't think I want to take you on. So they flee. And therefore, now you, when you do the math here, do you have the value of 30? You divide that by 2, and that comes up to 15. And we minus the 5 that we cost for display equals a plus 10 units of fitness. Now, once you get through all that, you start thinking, okay, what if all the animals in a population employed a hawk strategy? Well, that's not good, and nature won't allow that because nature is always striving for what's called an evolutionary stable strategy. So if you have all hawks, they will end up as a group with a minus 15 units. Now you just imagine, how long are you going to survive on the planet Earth using this much energy to get this much? Not very long. You're going to vanish in a hurry. So that doesn't work for nature. So now let's say all the animals in a group employ the dove strategy. Yeah, I'm not going to fight you. You're not going to fight me, but we're going to go around strutting our stuff all the time, putting on this huge animated display. Well, we're all going to end up here. The average, notice I said the average payoff. Remember, 50% of the time you don't win. 50% of the time you do win. So by the time this is all worked out, not every single animal in the group gets a plus 10. Not all of them do, only half of them do. And even a plus 10 fitness, remember, doesn't work out. This is my minimum amount for life-sustaining energy and to produce offspring. So I'm actually 20 units down, so that doesn't work out either. We need more than this. We need far more than 10. You know, 30, you may be able to get by with a little less than 30, but you've got to have somewhere near that. So nature created what's called a mixed evolutionary stable strategy, in which there had to be some combination of animals utilizing a hawk strategy and animals utilizing a dove strategy to achieve equilibrium. So then, and you know, I'm not going to go over this part here, but just know this. So knowing that, they decided to assign values. In other words, they used the letter P to describe hawk strategy. They used the number and the symbol 1 minus P, and the reason being that you cannot have, if hawks equal 1, doves have to equal 1. It can get a little confusing there, but at the end of the day, they plugged in all of these and they went searching for the value of P. Solve P in this mathematical formula here. And here's what came up. And they proved this out in the field. They proved this by observing elephant seals. They observed it with lions, with East African hunting dogs, with wolves, one predatory group after another. And this proved to be extremely accurate out in the wild. And here's what it came up to be. P equaled 0.57. In other words, it was 57% of the time the animals would employ what's called the hawk strategy for their optimal fitness, and the other times for the hawk strategy, 1 minus P equaled 0.43, and that was for the dove. So there you have it. In other words, to achieve optimal fitness, it behooved the animal to employ the hawk strategy 50% of the time, 57 out of 100 times whenever he encountered another opponent for a valuable resource. There you go. Now that individual, nature definitely favors that individual because that individual will be able to pass their genes forward. And that is the very beginning of aggression. From a natural, evolutionary, stable strategy arises out of that, all these numbers and formulas. Hey, you, it would behoove you to employ an aggressive attack immediately strategy 57 times out of 100. Game over. So guys, that is the beginning of aggression on the planet Earth, utilizing a model known as game theory. Now tomorrow, I'm going to talk about how this all plays into acquiring units of fitness for territory and control within a group. And once I have that, now we're ready to take all of this, put it into today's domestic dog, the one that lives in your household. And we will keep referring back to this. But today, set the stage for you to understand why aggression is so natural with our dogs. Again, there are many other variables. Depends on your genetic baseline. Are you more determined? Are you faster? Are you smarter? Are you stronger? But it doesn't matter. At the end of the day, we're talking two individuals. It's just a matter of which strategy they want to employ at that moment. And this shows here that nature favors the attacking strategy when it comes to social predators governed by the law of limited resources. So there you go. So when we later this week show you what you need to do with your dog, how to stop your dog from employing the hawk strategy at that moment, at least you can rest assured that this action started from natural origin, an evolutionary origin. Wrap your head around that. Because if you can do that, I promise you, I can help you be able to, at the minimum, at least manage this. At least take the dog out of this whole equation. Just say, dog, tell you what, we're going to employ Brian's strategy today. Not this one. But this is the key, is to understanding why your dog does what it does. And you have to know that before you can even begin to embark upon training or modifying that very natural behavior that they have. So I hope I didn't bore you to death. I had to go down this road. I have to go all the way deep into a periodic table from time to time because you have to understand. I have to give you a reason to understand why your dogs do some of the things that they do, regardless of the household they live in, regardless of what you do as an owner. It's just called being Canis Lupus Familiaris, wolf gray domesticated, governed by game theory. All right, guys, if you have any questions on this, I know this can get a little deep. I can definitely get a little deeper on it. Send them to me, Brian with the Y at TameTheWild.com. Put them in the thread of the Facebook thread. And if you found this information beneficial, of course, please share it. Share it out there with someone that you know or think may benefit from it. Okay, stay tuned. If you got a dog this week that's the least bit aggressive, the least bit reactive, you will not want to miss these videos. So I'll check you guys out tomorrow. Be prepared to learn a little bit more. Enjoy the rest of your Easter Sunday with your family.